one over there.
Pardon?
Don't fall in.
I won't. I won't fall in. So we're going into the Harecastle Tunnel. There used to be two tunnels here, but the first one, they had to close it due to subsidence. The first one was built by Brinley and this one by Telford. First time for everything. So after you go through, they close the gates behind you. There's a ventilation system in the tunnel that sucks all the fumes out. I get the picture. So the noise you can hear is the fans they've put on to ventilate it, and it is quite loud. The through draft that creates is quite incredible, and it makes it cold as well, but also it's making my eyes water. The boat in front of me, see, the guy's got he's got a headlight on which is just wrapped around the top of his head. I'm on the back of it, he's got a red light, it's a good idea, I'll have to get one of those. Incredible feat of engineering, I think they built this in a dead straight line. I wonder how many bricks were laid in the building of this. I know this has been done many times on YouTube, but obviously for us it's a brand new experience. Just incredible. Right, here's the first section that gets a bit lower, you can see it. They've painted yellow fluorescent on it. It's not critical at the moment, I haven't got to stoop down yet. some point in its history they had a system of electric tugs to pull them through the tunnel. You can occasionally see where the fixings for the cables were on the roof. And also originally this tunnel was built with a tow path. They actually used to bring the horses through here, but when they reconfigured it to get it open again, they took the tow path away, which has actually made it a bit wider. But God, what it must have been like bringing a horse through here. Not to mention the mess the horses would have made. You're going to walk all through it. Now I've actually caught the boat in front up, so I've obviously been going faster than him. I'll slow right down now. Section, you can see the yellow they've painted to warn you that the roof's going to get lower. Still not critical, I've still not got a bend down. Stooping down so I don't bash my head. Spooky man. Is narrower here, literally just about the width of the boat. can see the end of the tunnel now. That was interesting, because when I had to stoop down to steer, it just completely threw me, and I ended up going up into the wall. So play was interrupted. I have to see what damage I've done to the chimney, because that hit the wall. Interesting, to say the least. As the sunscreen man says, do one thing that scares you every day. Well, that's my scare for today. Another funny thing is they got skeletons painted on the wall, because it's supposed to be haunted. Immediately after the Harecastle Tunnel is this lock, which is a double lock. There's two side by side here. Going to inspect the damage in a minute. Don't see them very often. So that's the view of the two lock apertures at the other end of the Harecastle Tunnel. The Canal Tavern. Over there is the entrance to the Macclesfield Canal, immediately before the two locks. There's a Lidl right on the canal side at the locks. Very useful. There's another dual set of locks. Something else I've noticed, the shuttering on the canal banks is badly rusted in this area, and I'm just wondering if it's anything to do with the rust that's in the water, the iron deposits. But it is very corroded. So two lock chambers. I guess there must be a decent supply of water here. Otherwise they'd have to just use the one lock to conserve the water supply. So there is another boat now in the other lock on its way down. So the third set of locks after the tunnel is back to a single lock, and it looks like there's some volunteers there. If there are, it'd be a result. So there were no volunteers. Whatever they were, they buggered off. This is Red Bull Lock, I guess, or the pub's called Red Bull. So this is the Macclesfield Canal, which you turn left off after the Harecastle Tunnel, and it actually wraps around in like a giant figure of eight, and I'm actually standing on what is the aqueduct going over the Trent Mersey. So it's a canal over the top of a canal. Incredible engineering to think this is all done a couple of hundred years ago. And that's it looking back the other way. So this is walking towards the Trent and Mersey from the Macclesfield Canal. So that's the view of Harecastle Tunnel from the other end. Didn't film it coming out yesterday on the boat. One or two things happened in the tunnel that knocked the camera over and just didn't get done. It really illustrates the orangeness of the water here though. All the rust that comes from the rocks. And you can see the entrance to the now disused tunnel over on the right hand side there, behind the black rover that's parked there. Preston Brook, 30 miles. Shardlow, 62 miles. There's the rescue boat moored at the end of the tunnel. And there's the disused entranceway on the north end of the tunnel. So the rusty coloured water doesn't seem to discourage the local waterfowl. They all seem to be quite happy swimming in the murk. Not sure I'd like to jump in there and swim though. Well, oh dear, tunnel damage. Made a right mess of the canopy. Scratched along the top there. That's not such a big deal. I can easily give that a sand down and put a new coat of paint on that. And then the other thing it did was hit the top of my chimney cowl. It's hit it so hard it's banged it on there now. I can't get it off. I'm gonna have to unbolt it and try it from the other side. Tunnels, who'd go through a tunnel?